स्पीड. नाउ द टॉपिक इज कमिंग इन द मोशन ऑफ द मोशन इन द फ्लेम इज वेलोसिटी. व्हाट इज द वेलोसिटीज रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ डेफिनेशन ऑफ द वेलोसिटीज रेट ऑफ चेंज ऑफ displacement, rate of change of displacement is called velocity. Rate of change of displacement is called velocities. It means velocity is a vector quantity. V vector is equal to dx over. But it is the instantaneous velocity, V instantaneous. Here this is the instantaneous velocities. This is the instantaneous velocity. And V instantaneous is equal to dx over dt, where x is displacement. Now, if we are interested to know the instantaneous velocity, means at particular instant, what is the velocity? If a particle is moving from point A to B, if we are interested to know the velocity at point C, right, the actual velocity at point C is called the instantaneous velocity. If a particle is moving from A to B, from this path, there are various type of velocities which is coming in the path of AB. Now, if we are interested to know the velocity at point C, it means the instantaneous velocity at point C is equal to dx over dt. But we have to know the velocity is a vector quantity. It means dx over vector by dt. Now, we define the average velocities. Average velocities. What is the average velocities? In when the particle is moving from A to B, there are various velocities which are coming from A to B. The average of these all the velocities in the track of AB is known as average velocities. Average velocity means it is the ratio of total displacement to total time. Now, what is the average velocities? V average is equal to delta x over delta t. This is the, where x is the, delta means a interval. From A to B, this is a large interval, and this is called as average velocities. If we are rewrite it in differential form, then V instantaneous is equal to limit delta t tends to 0 delta x over delta t. This is called instantaneous velocity. This is the average velocity, and this average velocity becomes the instantaneous velocities. How it converts the instantaneous velocities? If delta t tends to 0, it means the time is infinitely small. Hence, this average velocity changes to the velocity of instantaneous terms. What is the unit? Now we are using the units of velocities. Unit of velocity is meter per second. This is the unit which we are using. Now there are various conversions which are very useful for that. The first conversion, we have to remember this conversion is if the velocities are giving in meter per second, if the velocities are giving generally in kilometer per hour, the velocities are coming conversion of kilometer per hour to meter per second. This is the important conversion. If the velocity of a particle is given in kilometer per hour, and if we interested to convert it to meter per second, how it converts kilometer per hour changes to meter per second if we multiply the factor of 5 by 8. We have to remember this. If we have 72 kilometer per hour is the velocities, and we multiplied by the 5 by 18 factor, it is converted into meter per second. B is meters. We have to remember these conversions. If the velocity is given in kilometer per hour, if we multiply 5 by 18 factor, this is converted into meter per second. This is the important factor we have to remember. If we are the opposite sense, then we multiply 18 by 8.